Hello everyone and welcome back to another video of Political Science and International Relations. My previous lecture was based on World War I, and if you are interested in knowing the facts, causes, events and everything about World War I, kindly watch my previous lecture. After studying World War I, the next most important topic and major topic I believe is to study about the League of Nations. Because it was established through the Treaty of Versailles, and this treaty was an important part of World War I as it made very harsh demands on Germany. This lecture series consists of three parts basically, and we'll be studying about the League of Nations, that how it evolved and establishment, and what were the achievements and successes of the League of Nations. We'll be looking into the causes and reasons behind the ineffectiveness of the League of Nations. However, this is part one of this lecture, which deals with evolution, establishment and achievements of the League of Nations. Part two, which I'll inshallah create later on, will deal with problems, failures of League of Nations. And lastly, part three will be based on the evaluation, analysis and assessment on the role of League of Nations. So let's begin. The League of Nations. So it was an international organization basically, and it was headquartered in Geneva in Switzerland, which was established after the World War I to provide a forum for resolving international disputes. Because the World War I hua tha, that was such a catastrophic event in the human history. The League was basically created and established, you know, to overcome and reduce these international disputes and conflicts. The League was based on the 14 points of President Woodrow Wilson, and he believed that an organization would be able to mitigate any inequalities in the peace terms, and the League would try to alleviate and reduce international conflicts. So the Covenant of the League of Nations came into effect in 1920, immediately after the end of the World War I. And the predecessor of the UN was the League of Nations, because baad mein yehi League of Nations jo hai na, it died, because the League later in 1930s died of its own contradiction, and its resources were absorbed into UN. UN baad mein ban gaya tha, which is a global organization. Theek hai. We'll study about this in part two. We'll be looking into the problems and failures of the League of Nations and the actual causes and reasons behind that. So that will then it will be more clear. Okay. Anyhow, the League was formed through Treaty of Versailles, and there was a clause in the Treaty of Versailles which was related to the promotion of international cooperation and how to achieve a global peace through collective security. So this was all the introduction about the League of Nations. We'll be studying about the League of Nations, the background. So the devastation which was caused by the Great World War I had shown to the countries that maintenance of peace was a proactive effort which was needed which could be only achieved through coordination and compromise. So it was, I told you before, it was an idea and agenda of President Woodrow Wilson. He was an American president, and this idea was given by him and presented by him after the World War I. When the League was formed, it was kind of an international police force which was made up of different representatives of many countries, because Wilson aimed at making this League to look like and be like a world parliament, you know, jahan pe har country ka representative baith ke, and they would discuss and resolve the international disputes and issues, the global issues, and they would try to help other countries and poor and weaker countries to, you know, come out of these issues, and peace jo hai wo rahega, it would be achieved through collective security. The League was an international organization that would try to settle disputes without resorting and glorifying war, kyunki matlab jo World War I ho gaya tha usne clearly show kiya tha ke how this war have deteriorated the world map, and you know, the geography, the world geography usse kis tarah kharab ki, because it also led to the fall of great empires, Russian Empire tha, the Ottoman Empire, the Austro-Hungarian Empire, ye sab jo the na, to ये था, ठीक है. सो इफ यू टॉक अबाउट इट्स मेंबरशिप, इनिशियली देर वर 42 मेंबर्स एंड लेटर मेंबरशिप वाज इंक्रीज्ड कंप्राइजिंग ऑफ 60 कंट्रीज, बट द परमानेंट मेंबर्स वर ब्रिटेन, फ्रांस, इटली एंड जापान. मैं आपको इधर एक बात बता दूं, यू नो इट वाज प्रेसिडेंट वुड्रो विल्सन, द अमेरिकन प्रेसिडेंट, हु प्रेजेंटेड हिज 14 पॉइंट्स व्हिच वर द यू नो व्हिच लेड टू द एस्टैब्लिशमेंट ऑफ द लीग ऑफ नेशन. बट द यूएस, इट्स you know very ironic to say that US did not join the League of Nations due to its isolationist policy, because it wanted to keep itself away from the problems and issues of other states, and it did not want to get indulged in global issues. And if you talk about USSR, it did not join the league. It was its own consent that it does not want to join the league. But Germany was basically not allowed to join the league because it was punished. This was as a punishment for, because Germany initiated and started the World War II. Aims of the League of Nations. So, what were the purpose of, you know, the establishment of League of Nations? क्योंकि जो भी एक और international organization बनती है तो उसके कुछ aims and principles होते हैं on which it basically stands. तो we'll study the aims of the League of Nations. तो there were basically the main aims of League of Nations were to maintain world peace through collective security. How? Through collective security, that by dealing with disputes among nation and to discourage aggression from any nation. ठीक है, क्योंकि जब डिस्प्यूट्स को सेटल आउट कर लेंगे पीसफुली तो दैट वुड ऑटोमेटिकली यू नो maintain peace and cooperation amongst nation, तो through collective security. ठीक है, इसका example ऐसे ले लेते हैं कि अगर एक nation एक state दूसरे state पे attack करे, so the member states of the league would act together to restrain the aggressor by means of economic and military measures. economic and military measures का मतलब है to impose sanctions on the state. ठीक है, against the aggressive nation. हम इंटरनेशनल लॉ में पढ़ते हैं, देयर इज अ सब्जेक्ट इंटरनेशनल लॉ, उसके अंदर हम पढ़ते हैं पीसफुल सेटलमेंट ऑफ डिस्प्यूट्स एंड कोअर्सिव सेटलमेंट्स ऑफ डिस्प्यूट्स. तो कोअर्सिव सेटलमेंट ऑफ डिस्प्यूट्स में हम पढ़ते हैं यू नो एग्रेसिव नेशन या एग्रेसर के नेशन के ऊपर जो है ना सैंक्शंस या एम्बार्गो लगता है, पैसिफिक ब्लॉकेड लगा दिया जाता है, और यू नो इस तरह के बहुत सारे मेजर्स हैं थ्रू विच यू नो देयर कुड बी सेटलमेंट ऑफ डिस्प्यूट. तो ये थी एग्जांपल. इकोनॉमिक सैंक्शंस माइट इंक्लूड रिफ्यूजल टू शिप एसेंशियल्स मटेरियल टू दिस नेशन और अ टोटल एम्बार्गो ऑन ट्रेड. आई टोल्ड यू. तो मिलिट्री सैंक्शंस माइट इंक्लूड मिलिट्री एक्शंस बाय मेंबर स्टेट अगेंस्ट अ कंट्री. ठीक है, समझ आ रही है ना आपको. And the other is, you know, to encourage international cooperation in order to solve economic and social problems. So eventually it will improve living conditions for all the people. However, other aims include safeguard for independence of countries and their frontiers, to encourage nations and to reduce their armaments. Because agar aapki kyunki us time pe after the World War I through treaty of Versailles Germany ko kaha tha ki aapne jo hai na apne arms kam karne hai, theek hai, kyunki isne war ko initiate किया था. सो द वर्ल्ड फियर्ड ये ना कि ये दोबारा कर ले. तो यू नो देर वर सेवरल ट्रीटीज विच वर साइंड विद मैनी अदर कंट्रीज कि वो अपने आप को डिसआर्म करें. ठीक है, अपनी आर्मी को रिड्यूस करें. दे वुड हैव टू डीमिलिटराइज देमसेल्फ. ठीक है, सो द अदर इज टू ब्लेंड ऑल द मेंबर्स ऑफ द लीग टू रिस्पेक्ट एंड प्रिजर्व टेरिटोरियल इंटीग्रिटी एंड पॉलिटिकल इंडिपेंडेंस ऑफ द स्टेट्स, वेदर इफ इट्स अ लार्ज स्टेट और अ स्मॉल स्टेट, अ स्ट्रॉन्गर स्टेट और अ वीकर स्टेट. ठीक है, एंड टू सेटल प्रॉब्लम्स दैट विच माइट लीड टू हॉस्टिलिटी बिटवीन नेशंस, सच एज कॉलोनियल डिस्प्यूट्स हैं, रिफ्यूजी प्रॉब्लम है, एंड कॉन्फ्लिक्ट्स ओवर इंटरनेशनल national law. So this is in order that these problems do not worsen or they lead to war. ठीक है, and member states were required to submit all their disputes to arbitration. हम इसको you know peaceful settlement of disputes पढ़ते हैं international law में, and it includes the means of mediation, conciliation, intervention, negotiation. These are all peaceful settlement of disputes, by which disputes can be settled through peaceful means. And to encourage international cooperation in order to solve economic and social problems, one of the clause was that secret treaties between nations were forbidden. Or enforcement of Treaty of Versailles के अंदर एक क्लॉज था that would encourage trade and economic social agencies and health care so as to end slavery. तो Treaty of Versailles के बहुत ज़्यादा क्लॉज थे तो it dealt with these problems. ठीक है. And even this League of Nations was established on through Treaty of Versailles. Organizational structure of the League of Nations. Now if we talk about the structure and organization of the League, so it basically was based on General Assembly, the Council, agencies and Secretariat. ठीक है. अब जो जनरल असेंबली थी ना, इट वॉज दैट इन विच ईच मेंबर नेशन हैड वन वोट एंड दे हैड टू मेट एनुअली. इट्स फंक्शन वॉज टू डिसाइड द जनरल पॉलिसी एंड डिस्कस इंटरनेशनल डिस्प्यूट्स एंड प्रॉब्लम्स. फॉर एग्जाम्पल यू नो प्रपोज अ रिविजन फॉर पीस ट्रीटी एंड इट हैंडल्ड द फाइनेंस ऑफ द लीग. ठीक है, जितना भी फाइनेंशियल मैटर था जो लीग का वो इसने डील करना था. ठीक है. And there was this problem that a unanimous vote was needed for any important decisions. मतलब जितने भी member हैं इसमें league में, तो unanimous जो decision है ना, मतलब which is agreed by everyone, तो that had to be achieved and that was needed. But unfortunately that was difficult to achieve, क्योंकि अगर एक बात किसी for example 10 states को suit कर रही है तो maybe के 5-6 states को वो suit ना करे और वो उसके against जाए, तो you know a unanimous decision was very difficult to you know agree upon. ठीक है. So then there was this council. It was a smaller body than General Assembly and it met more often, at least thrice a year. And it advised the Assembly on what action to take. ये एक advisory council थी जो General Assembly को guide करती थी that what action now is to take. And it was the most powerful body of the League. It consisted of 4 permanent members. जो permanent members मैंने आपको बताए थे League के वही थे, which were Britain, France, Italy and Japan. And there were 4 temporary members as well, which was chosen by the assembly for every 3-year terms. और वो depend करता था कि मतलब हर 3 सालों के लिए कौन से 4 non-permanent members या temporary members होंगे. ठीक है. The numbers of temporary members were increased to 6 in 1922 and then it was later increased to 9 in 1926. The council's job was basically to deal with specific political disputes as they rose again, and decision had to be again unanimous. I told you, in its function of peacekeeping, it was expected that the League would operate as follow, that all disputes threatening war would be submitted to the League, and any member which resorted to war and it tried to break the covenant would face action by the rest. क्योंकि मैंने आपको बताया कि they would encourage peace through collective security, and collective security से इसी तरह peace achieve किया जा सकता है by dealing with disputes and to act together and to stop and discourage the aggressive nation. ठीक है. तो इसी तरह काउंसिल का काम था कि वो ये काम करेगी. ठीक है. एंड द काउंसिल वुड रिकमेंड व्हाट इफेक्टिव मिलिट्री, नेवल एंड एयर फोर्स द मेंबर्स शुड कंट्रीब्यूट टू द आर्म्ड फोर्सेस. देन देयर वाज दिस सेक्रेटरीट. It was headed by the Secretary General. इसका जो head था वो Secretary General था. ठीक है. And it consisted of various officials जो के who recorded and administered work and decisions of the League. ठीक है. वो बस इस League के सारे काम को administer करते थे and their task was to record everything. ठीक है. It looked after all the paperwork जो होता है, preparing agendas होते हैं, writing resolutions, reports and carrying out the decisions of the League. तो it had to dealt with these problems. प्रॉब्लम्स, ठीक है, ये इसके टास्क होते थे. एंड व्हेन द असेंबली मेट इन नवंबर 1920, इट वाज फर्स्ट मेट इन 1920, तो ऑलमोस्ट ऑल द एलाइड नेशंस हैड जॉइंड द लीग एंड सम ऑफ द न्यू यूरोपियन स्टेट्स एंड सेवरल न्यूट्रल कंट्रीज ऑल्सो जॉइंड. एंड इन 1935 आई टेल यू दैट द लीग हैड 62 मेंबर नेशंस. The main aim was secretariat was to organize the league, but it failed. वो फिर हम बाद में पढ़ेंगे the failure of the league. तो इसकी agencies थी, you know, small and special agencies were set up such as court of international justice. Justice international justice का court क्यों डाला था? So as to settle small disputes. Health committee बनाई थी to improve the conditions in countries में, the countries who are having poor health conditions, so the league would try to help them. And then there was international labor committee which would try to get the fair wages for the labor and poor people. Slavery committee थी and इसके अंदर फिर to end and prevent slavery. Refugee committee थी to return people to their homes after wars or disasters. So this was all about the organizational structure of the League of Nations. Achievements of the League of Nations. So during 1920s, the League of Nations successfully settled a number of disputes between small and weaker nations. ठीक है, weak nations. So when a dispute involved a great power, however, the League was the League often favored the more important country. क्योंकि परमानेंट मेंबर्स ही जो थे ना उसके, वो ग्रेट पावर्स थे उस टाइम. ठीक है, इट वाज ब्रिटेन, फ्रांस, इटली, जापान. यूएस वाज नॉट पार्ट ऑफ द लीग ऑफ नेशंस ड्यू टू इट्स ओन कंसेंट, बट जब एक ग्रेट पावर की बात आती थी तो लीग जो है ना हमेशा उस चीज पे जो है ना इट रिमेंड साइलेंट. ठीक है, सो इन 1920 इट सेटल्ड अ डिस्प्यूट बिटवीन स्वीडन एंड फिनलैंड इन ओवर द आलैंड आइलैंड्स केस. And then in the following year, same year, the Yugoslavian troops jo the na from withdrew from Albania when the League threatened to impose economic sanctions on Yugoslavia. ये एक बहुत बड़ी achievement थी League की, that क्योंकि उसने जो है ना order किया Yugoslavian troops को कि वो जो है ना Albania से withdrew करे, so क्योंकि वो इस पर economic sanctions impose कर लेगा. So this was one of the aim of the League of Nations के वो जो है ना इट वुड मेंटेन वर्ल्ड पीस थ्रू कलेक्टिव सिक्योरिटी. एंड थ्रू कलेक्टिव सिक्योरिटी आई टोल्ड यू बिफोर दैट दे वुड इम्पोज इकोनॉमिक एंड मिलिट्री सैंक्शंस ऑन द एग्रेसिव नेशन. इन 1925 द लीग स्टॉप्ड ग्रीस फ्रॉम अटैकिंग बल्गेरिया बाय थ्रेटनिंग एन इकोनॉमिक एम्बार्गो. अगेन इट थ्रेटन्ड agrees that it would impose this economic embargo which prevented the outbreak of war in the Balkan. Balkan was the region between Middle East and usme war hone se jo hai na wo bach gaya tha. Theek hai, it also solved border disputes in other part of Eastern Europe. And besides settling disputes, the League encouraged cooperation between countries and it helped to solve social and economic problems. Then there were two committees formed for this purpose, the Disarmament Commission and the Mandates Commission. The Disarmament Commission worked to persuade member countries to reduce the size of their armed forces and to cut down their stocks of weapon. क्योंकि जितना ज़्यादा military जो है थोड़ी कम होगी तो उसमें जो है ना फिर मतलब aggression की possibility कम होती है. ठीक है, you don't fight for your objectives anymore and you just work for maintaining peace and cooperation among nations. ठीक है, तो लीग का यही aim था. And for this purpose, it formed a commission, the Disarmament Commission and the Mandates Commission. Jo tha, it kept an eye on the German and Turkish colonies, which were put under the temporary rule of Britain and France by the peace treaties. It also supervised the administration of mandated territories. ने जो territories Britain and France को दी गई थी, तो mandates commission का ये काम था कि वो जो है ना इन mandated territories की administration देखेगी. ठीक है, so this was all the achievements of the League of Nations. And स्पेशल कमिटीज ये भी एक अचीवमेंट थी लीग ऑफ नेशंस की, कि इट द लीग ऑल्सो हैड द टास्क ऑफ मेकिंग द वर्ल्ड अ बेटर वन, यू नो, अ बेटर वर्ल्ड आफ्टर द वर्ल्ड वॉर वन. क्योंकि एक मुल्क, दुनिया जो है वो किस चीज से गुजर के गई थी, जिसने पूरी चीजें तबाह कर दी थी, कंट्रीज को तबाह कर दिया था, नेशंस को तबाह कर दिया था. तो नाउ इट एम दैट यू नो मेकिंग द वर्ल्ड अ बेटर वन. स्पेशल कमिटीज वर सेट अप टू लुक इनटू द बिग प्रॉब्लम्स ऑफ द वर्ल्ड एंड सजेस्टेड सॉल्यूशंस फॉर दैट. सो देयर वाज दिस हेल्थ ऑर्गेनाइजेशन एस्टैब्लिश्ड फॉर इम्प्रूविंग वर्ल्ड्स हेल्थ यू नो. एंड देन इन सिमिलरली 1919 इंटरनेशनल लेबर ऑर्गेनाइजेशन ILO एम्ड टू इम्प्रूव द कंडीशन ऑफ पीपल. इट वॉज एस्टैब्लिश्ड एज एन एफिलिएटेड बॉडी ऑफ द लीग. ये जो जितने भी ये कमीशन्स के बारे में, इन कमिटीज के बारे में मैं आपको बता रही हूँ, देवर काइंड ऑफ एसोसिएटेड एंड एफिलिएटेड टू द लीग. एंड देन In 1921, the World Law Court and the Permanent Court of International Justice, it was based in Hague in the Netherlands, and it tried to settle the legal disputes between countries. And iska jo structure tha, wo aisa tha ke it consisted of 15 judges of different nationalities, and it dealt with legal disputes between states. And then other special committees had the job of improving child welfare, women rights, stopping drug smuggling and helping refugees. The league helped to find homes for refugees and arranged international loans for poor nation. It also established some technical organization which provided experts to deal with problems concerning health, drugs, refugees, communication, labor condition tha, finance tha. These organization attempted to prevent the trade in drugs and slaves as well as helping backward countries to improve their health condition. मैंने आपको पहले भी बताया है in previous slides के जो मतलब जिन countries poor थे and they were having these poor living conditions, तो उसके लिए जो है ना several committees were set up और फिर जो है ना to improve. This was one of the aim of the League of Nations. तो this is all. This marks the end of part 1 of the League of Nations. I have covered and discussed the establishment, organization and structure of the League of Nations. I have discussed its achievements. So the problems and failures of League of Nations has been discussed in another video, which is part 2 of this topic. There is a kind request in the end that kindly give this video a thumbs up if it was helpful, and subscribe to my channel. I'll be coming up with more interesting and informative lecture, as these topics are also very important and helpful for competitive exams, you know, the CSS, PMS. So this was all in part 1. So I'll meet you in the next part. Take care. Bye.